Hello peeps, this time I'm going to show you the more usual form of the FENOT of which I showed you in the other version, the 5 lead 11 byte. That one was based off a 5 lead 6 byte knot where we have one byte more than leads, and now I'm going to show you one that is based off a 5 lead 4 byte knot, and I'm going to show you a smaller one for the sake of the length of the video. And it's going to be a 5 lead 9 byte. You can always make them larger, the whole thing is very repetitive. The other thing that I want to show you is the base knot for this is a 2 lead Turk set. And I was asked to show how to make a 2 lead Turk set. I'm going to show you the two versions because I show you the sober version. And I'm going to show you how to build or to tie a usual or normal one. The normal one always, the standing part comes out under the byte. See here, it comes out under. And we make an overhand knot, and that already creates the 2 lead 1 byte knot. As you can see, this is just the one coming out, but we only have one byte. Sorry, we only have... This is the one coming out, but we only have one byte. We could also move the working part round to meet the standing part to make it a bit clearer. But in the end, you can see, it's not so easy to see, but you only have this one byte. The other one is already on the other side. It's a bit difficult with the sober one, because you don't have any chance to lock this knot in, this overhand knot. So you come out over, and this is already, when I'm going to pull it this way, this is already our 2 lead 1 byte, but we did not have to make a tuck. The tuck already creates the next one. It's a bit complicated, but all has to do with this kind of knot not really being stable at all. And this is not completed. This has to be met up, or this has to meet up with the other one. And now we have a 2 lead 3 byte 1 2 lead 3 byte knot, what we want. Because now we go round a third time, and with every, as I said before, with every cycle we add two more leads, as this is a 2 lead knot. So with the third one we add 2, which means we have 3 lead 5 bytes. The next one is 4 lead 7 bytes, and the last one is 4 lead 9 bytes. So everything will be quite normal. It's all related, it's all mathematics, but once you start getting the picture, it's all very easy to understand. So what we do here, in this kind of knots, we use enlargement process 1. That means we are starting right of the standing part, or as I like to refer to it, below, because the direction changes, and if we refer to it as being below, it does not change. We always stay below the standing part when we are doing what we're doing. So we come out over when we're laying the tracks. Just this first round is simply laying the tracks, of course, and we go over, come out over, and we go in over and come out under. And as this is an even lead knot, we have the situation that we come out over and go in over on one side of the knot, and on the other side we come out under and go in under. In an odd lead knot, it would be always the same. We either come out over and go in over, or we come out under and go in under. So here, in this, we come out under, we go in under. And we go out over. Again, the right side, we come out over, we go in over, and we come out under. So, and here we come, we have almost finished this round, come out under. And now we are not following the standing part, but we do what we did the whole round. We came out under and we go in under again. So this, if we would tie a four lead knot now, would be the start of splitting the pairs. Which we can see on our next bite. If we would go in under here, over and under here, we then would be able to make a four lead seven bite Turk set. But we don't want this now because we want to have the middle part going over two under two. So we need to lay tracks again. We need to build another layer of new bites. You can see we have a new bite here, and by going over this already formed correct bite, we now make this to an unlocked bite too, and so now we are adding another layer of bites in the other one, which was the more difficult one, which I refer to of kind of building backwards when you using the direct build method and not concentrate on the enlargement. We built it towards the end, so that means we went under two at the end or over two, but now we come out over here, we have to go in over again, but we go over two. That's the difference. The other one would be over one and under two, and now we go in over two and under one. That's the main difference here, apart from following on the other side. That's the other major difference. So here, come out under, and now we go in under two. Out over one. Here we can easily see how we manage to see what we need to do to keep our path open. We go out over one, we go in over one, go out under. So the last one on this fourth round, we come out under, we go in under two, come out over one. So now we're going to do the last round, and as we can see there, our new bite already slipped under, but this is all very, very easy to see. You can easily see where you have to go. So now it's no question what we have to do. We are not building tracks anymore, so we have to lock in the loose bites. And what we are doing here is we have to go under where this cord, it goes under on both sides. To lock it in, we need to go under. And in the middle, we want to have something with two. And the logical thing is now to go over, and we go over two. And this one is under and under two, so we need to lock it on by going under. So we come out under, but that's not important here. We see what we have to do. We have to go over to lock this, and we have to go under 2 in the middle and over 2 here. See, and this is kind of, okay, where am I? Just grab them and see if it looks right. If you make a mistake, you will really see immediately. So we go in under, go over, over 2, and under 2. So now we've almost finished, but this last bite is missing. We always need to go in to meet the standing part. It's no matter where we go out, it's not important here, but we have to do this, otherwise we would miss out this last bite. So you can easily see it's a regular pattern, over 2 in this direction, under 2 in this direction, and over and under 2 on the bite sides, over 1 and under 1. And the showing you again how you count them, you take 2 parallel cords and count the ones in the corridor, but you count the outer ones too, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you have 5 leads, and you have, let me see, can I show you this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 bites. So, and what I said, you can make them larger if you want, no problem. And I hope you could follow, and hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching.